I swear to God when I come home.
Right, let's get married.
I'm gonna hold you so close. I swear to God when I come home, I'll never let go. Like a river I flow to the ocean I know. You pull me close, guiding me home. And I need you to know that we're falling so fast. We're falling like the stars, falling in love. And I'm not scared to say those words. With you I'm safe. We're falling like the stars, we're falling in love. I swear to God I can see 4 kids in no sleep. We'll have one on each knee, you and me. And when they've grown up, you're still the girl in the club. When I held your hair up, 'cause you had so much. God, every day he won't take you away. 'Cause without you, babe, I lose my way. Swear to God I can see 4 kids in no sleep. We'll have one on each knee, you and me. And when they've grown up, you're still the girl.
We've reached that moment. If you don't mind standing, so you can watch the most gorgeous woman in the city right now.
Like the stars. swear to God every day. Real quick, right before we get started, I want everybody to put your phone on vibrate. Amen. Put the phones up if you can't do that. And also, there are people here for that are videoing. So when you up taking your pictures, just try to stay out of their way. Amen?
Amen.
All right. All right. The Bible says when a man finds a wife, he finds favor.
Yes, sir.
Finds favor with the Lord. So I just want you to know right now that you're stepping into a realm of favor. And before we get started, I would ask a question. Who gave this woman to this man?
Her mother and I.
That's you there, Doc. Man. And let me say this here. This is kind of a big deal. So next time you clap, clap your hands like you're gonna clap them off.
Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on.
Yeah, we ain't at the courthouse, right? This took effort, so we're gonna need effort in your applause. Amen?
Amen.
Father, we give your name all the glory, the honor, and the praise today. We certainly magnify you for who you are and what you've done. We're praying for this joint family today, God, that you will shine your light, your glory, your mercy, your grace, more importantly, your favor on their lives, as they have made a decision to join each other in holy matrimony. We thank you right now. We already pray against any assignment, any challenges, anything that would break them. We bind it and take charge over it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
So it is.
I like Auntie from Chicago. She's necessary. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of friends and loved ones to celebrate the lives, one of the greatest moments in life,
yes, sir.
What God created, what he sanctioned. We are here to give recognition to the beauty of the love that is shared between Jeremy and Monique as they complete their family in holy matrimony.
Right.
That was a clap moment. Y'all work with me. Marriage is a contract not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with deep realization of the obligation and responsibilities. Marriage is the moment where hearts and souls are joined for eternity. Amen. That's a clap moment. We've already prayed for the couple, and we're going to get right into it for time's sake. Amen? So I'm going to ask you to unlock hands. And instead of our traditional vows, they have wrote their own vows.
All
right. That's a clap moment.
Right.
We're going to let the lady go first. I'm going to hold the mic, honey.
Okay. I first want to say I thank God for you.
Go ahead.
Jeremy, I tell you this all the time, but you are my best friend. I remember when I seen you for the first time and told our coworkers that you were going to be my husband. I never thought that on this day, Sunday, February 4th, I would be going from Curry to Garland. Sorry, y'all. I was nervous when I wrote this. Whew. I remember when you first came by my place and had to leave. Amara grabbed your leg, wrapped her body around you, and held on. I said, let him go. He will be back tomorrow. Now, here you are, coming home every day.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
That was a clap moment.
Thank you for stepping in to father my daughter.
Clap moment.
Thank you for being a great man, father, friend, and now husband. I have already loved you through sickness and health. I have already loved you through the good and bad. I had loved you when you were poor, and I will love you when you're rich. I promise that I will continue to love you through all of those things. I promise to wake up and be my best self every day. I am excited about our future and the things we have planned. Thank you for being the best man to and front for me. I promise to love you without conditions. Only thing I ask is for you to wait at least 2 years before giving me another child.
Jeremy has wrote his own vows, and let's see what type of emotions he able to tap into. Dun, 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 dun.
I'm going to try to wait 2 years, but I do. Monique, my best friend, my lover, my forever partner, and a beautiful soul. We've been through so much together, baby. And I stand with you today with our family and friends. And I like to share something that was significant to me. It was that time at the Riverwalk in San Antonio a few years ago. I remember we had a deep conversation in that moment, and I gave you all that was in my heart, all of my difficulties and insecurities, and the things I struggled with. You never once judged me or disregarded my expression. You helped me as we both cried, and you told me, baby, I'm right by your side. In that moment, you created a safe space for me, a space that every man craved to have. It was that moment I knew you was bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh.
All right, all right,
all right. All right. Yeah. Here you go, girl. Yeah.
Monique, I thank you for always pushing me to be a better man, encouraging me as the head of our household. Despite of my imperfections, you kept reminding me of the importance of my role in our family dynamic, telling me the truth that no one else has the courage to say. Even though your approach translates to my mind as harsh, like Proverbs chapter 27, verse 6, I know that wound is faithful. As your husband, I promise to communicate effectively. I promise to be evolving constantly. I promise to serve you in love. I promise to provide and protect this family. I promise to pay attention when you're hurting. I promise to love you through sickness and health. I promise to be here until God calls us home. I promise to love you unconditionally. I promise to remain faithful. Remember this. This is not the.
He said he promised to remain faithful.
Absolutely. Remember this. This is not the finish line. This is just the beginning.
I ain't crying. It's like a lot of wind coming from this side right here. These rings are a symbol of commitment to one another. You wear them with respect. You wear them, I always tell you men, you wear them to keep the chickens away. Amen. Y'all should have clapped right there. If somehow you lose your rings, you don't have your rings, the love should be in your heart.
Come on now.
Should know to respect each other when you're not around.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So we will bless these rings. Father, we give your name all the glory, the honor, and the praise. We ask you to bless these rings as a symbol of their love, God, and a symbol of their commitment. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Monique, I would like you to take Jeremy's hand and repeat after me. And place the ring on his finger and repeat after me. Jeremy.
Jeremy.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And that I am choosing to share my life.
And that I am choosing to share my life.
And this journey with you.
In this journey with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
It's a clap moment.
I give you this ring.
With the pledge to love you.
With the pledge to love you.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
Clap moment. Place the ring on her finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And that I am choosing to share my life's journey with you.
And I'm choosing to share my life's journey with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With the pledge to love you.
With the pledge to love you.
Today.
Today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
Amen. Clap moment. So they have chosen to do our sand ceremony. So at this time, ladies, if y'all would help her, we're gonna make our way to the table. Y'all can remain seated. We need that camera moved.
Which way do I go?
And the tripod, straight through there.
I'm staying right here. I'm staying right here.
No, no, you come over here too. And the kids. We join the separate lives together. Two separate bottles of sand symbolizing separate lives, separate families, separate set of friends. They represent all that you are and all you would ever be as individuals. They also represent your lives before the day. I will take sand to start the foundation. Clap moment. Won't open. Where is Uncle Junior? It won't open. So this is the foundation. That's the foundation. I would ask that, Monique, you take this one. Jeremy, you take this one. I want you two to come, you two to come over here.
Amias.
Yeah. So you're gonna pull for your brother and you're gonna pull. We can go. Oh, hold on, sir. I got a knife. Yeah, it'll help you. Uncle Junior, we need you over here, sir.
It's not open.
Coming. Oh my God. Get it out here like coming.
Is it taped?
It ain't taped.
If I open this thing, I'm gonna look at you so hard.
No, you ain't gonna let me. Anybody got a knife?
Oh, we're gonna join this together.
It ain't moving.
Turn it again.
It don't go that way.
Can you pop it?
I'm trying to. Yeah, this.
Can't open it.
Yeah.
Go
Bro, it ain't moving.
She went to get a knife.
Ma'am, you up?
She went to get a knife.
Yeah, oh, there we go. No, no. You ain't gonna show me up.
I wasn't gonna try to show you up.
You ain't got lotion on your hand. You show me up. I mess with you.
He did that.
Oh, them Chicago goons with the knives. Yeah. 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 He from O Block. All right, we're going to put it there. Yeah. At the same time, we're going to pull here. If it all don't fit, just make sure we get most of it in at the same time. Get some more now.
Okay, Mom.
All right, that's good. So just as all these sayings can never be separate again, that's how you guys' lives are now. Amen?
Amen.
We're going back. Let's go. As tradition, there is a question that needs to be asked. Before I ask that question, I'm going to ask my Uncle Leroy to stand up. All right. Just stand there when I ask this question. Now, if there's anybody here that objects to this union, you can speak now, forever hold your peace, but look over there. We all good? All right, I appreciate that, huh? Right before we pronounce them, the father of the groom is going to sing. That's a clap moment.
What's it gonna be, baby?
True words, yeah, yeah, yeah. Baby, just you and me. Whoa, oh, whoa, oh, whoa, oh, 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 oh,
oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, and you'll be my perfect bride. Would you just think about it, baby? Think about it, baby. You and me will be together, girl, rain, sleet, snow, no matter what the weather. Just think about it, baby. Think about it, girl. We'll be making love for eternity. You ain't a family. Girl, I'm on my knees saying, marry me. Your baby, whoa, 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 a picket fence, a dog in a house, me, few things to me, breakfast in the morning while I'm taking a garbage shot. Would you just marry me, marry me, marry me, marry me, marry me, marry me, marry me.
Well, your wife was looking at you. Y'all might not even go to the reception the way she was looking at you. Straight to the car. So we're reaching that point now where we get down to the real business. I want to tell y'all, whatever y'all done before today, you may have argued before, you may have paid a few bills,
yes.
Maybe went shopping together, but you ain't never done it as husband and wife.
Come on, come on.
So what that means is everything is new.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't argue with him like he your boyfriend or your fiance. You can't argue with her like that's your gal, you're somebody you're kicking it with. It's gonna be your wife, amen. And I just want to speak for our family. It's always a blessing when we can marry our people into a happy situation. I'm super excited. I'm going to tell you, a man who made a lot of mistakes, man. You can survive your ignorance, but the best way to not have to survive is just to not be ignorant.
Amen.
That
Amen.
just takes everything away.
Amen.
So I want to shout out to my wife. We've been together since 1996. Woo! Go ahead and stand up. Let me mine. Go ahead and stand up right there. Go ahead and stand up. Yeah. Go ahead and stand up. Stand up. Stand up. What's where them kids at? Stand up, kids. Stand up, kids. Stand up, kids. Stand up, kids. So simply put, you can get it right or you can get it wrong. Just get it right. Don't put hurt in her. Don't put hurt in him. Just get it right. Amen. So with all that being said, by the power invested in me, this is that moment right here. The weather come roll. Y'all should be making some noise right now. Y'all should really be screaming right now. So by the power invested in me, through God in the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Hey, 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 hey. Time out. Time out. Don't get the kissing yet. Just hold up, hold up. You gonna get that shot, okay? So we pronounced them as husband and wife. Let me step out the way because y'all look ready. You may now kiss your bride. Come on, come on, come on, make some noise in this place.
Waltzing like somebody planned it all.
bucket. Look at my baby.
Thank you. the love journey that's about to begin.
I'm gonna tell you more. Thank you. we all feeling out there, everybody? What a beautiful, beautiful occasion this is. It is an absolute honor and a pleasure to be able to enjoy this moment with Mr. and Mrs. Garland.
Good, bad, happy, or sad? Hey.
Attention,
y'all doing? I need everyone's attention. I'm loud, but I don't want to talk over everybody. I want to talk soft today because I might cry. But I'm giving a toast. I just want to speak on behalf of my daughter and my new son. Hey. But I want to say something about Jeremy and Monique, because this generation, you don't see them last long. Soon as they go through something, we broke up, it's over. But I witnessed them from the beginning, go through some tough times, some challenging times, to some times where they could have walked away, but they say, no, I'm gonna see what's wrong with me, I'm gonna work on me. And Monique said, I'm gonna work on me. And one thing I love about Jeremy, when he first came, it's some things, because y'all don't know my daughter, she know it, she got it, she moved fast, she used to be impatient. I love you. But I seen one thing I love about them, they always call me for advice and they accept it. Jeremy, mama, this and that. I said, well, son, you gotta do this, gotta do that. Monique, mama, now tell me, I'm tripping. Now this and that. I said, Monique, you tripping. I just tell her the truth. That's the thing. You have to tell young couples, especially, the truth. Don't teach them how to walk away. Teach them how to, y'all know. But I'm only speaking on behalf of them on what I witnessed from the beginning. From the first day she said, Mama, I met somebody. You know, we friends or whatever. So Jeremy would come over to Monique's house. I would be there. And when he leave, he just like, he cool with it. He waiting on a hug and he getting ready to leave out the door. I say, girl, go hug that boy. I don't want to. And I told Jeremy, how do you like her? I'm sorry, that's my child. I know she didn't like the hug. You know, he said, well, Mama, I love her. I'm just gonna wait. And he waited patiently, and look where we at today. That's my girl right there. I've seen them struggle. I've seen them get together as a family and go make it happen. If they didn't have, they weren't out just begging around. Hey, I'm gonna tell y'all the truth. Can I tell y'all something that's truthful? They will get in that vehicle, the kids got their little tablets, and Monique and Jeremy will go DoorDash. I'm telling you. They just did it as a team. I don't care if it was DoorDash, hashtag, whatever. They did it together. So this is why I know they're gonna make it as a married couple. Because they already fought through the tough times, so they know how to make it happen together. And one thing I told them, and I'm gonna sit down, I told them, the way y'all gonna last is first keep God. That's the only way. And I told them the second thing, y'all gotta have communication. You have got to. And I told them, y'all can get through anything. And then they got a team, like their parents, all of them. They got a team of people. Where's Ron and Miss? That's Jeremy's dad, best friend. They give them advice, godly advice, good advice, and that's what they need. They don't need the messy people or nothing like that. So I thank God for my new son and my daughter. I know they're gonna make it. I can't wait. The Garland!
Young man, I don't have to say how I feel about my daughter, because she knows I love her. I love all my daughters. I'm a father of six daughters.
Where's the other speaker at?
Spread out.
Let me go grab him. I'll bring him over here for you.
Yeah.
But, you know, not taking nothing from his parents, because they did a wonderful job with this young man. But, you know, it made me do the fact that y'all heard it.
Are you the father of Jeremy? Yeah. Let me get your mic up.
Artists and what have you. So one quality, you know, your daughter's gonna always try to find, when they find something in another man that they can relate to.
I'll get you next, don't worry.
They can do that.
She got me all distracted with my mic system.
Who did? I just want y'all to meet. Who did? And his dad.
Okay.
Okay, you know. And when I met, first impression is everything. And he left a wonderful impression on. You know, and I feel, when a parent don't have to worry about their child, when it comes to the person that they're dating, that speaks volume.
Yeah.
Because there have been some that came across our path. I'd be like,
Yeah, that one ain't right.
Nah.
That one ain't right.
But Jeremy, though I love him, I'm glad you found her, because we know the scripture. He that findeth a wife findeth a good thing. And she's wife material. She grew up under this. She know how to be a wife. She had a good coach.
That's a clap moment.
She had a good coach.
That's right, that's right.
I'm proud of you, Mo. I feel, I'm glad that you said yes to his proposal.
Yes.
I don't think you could have met a better family to be a part of.
Yeah.
I love this family. They got came in.
Tell us, stop being lazy.
His dad, we clicked.
Yes, sir.
It's like my brother, and I know I think I still got under 3 minutes and longer than the brother. But to the Garlands.
Yeah.
You took the Curry away and replaced it with Garland.
All right.
That's a clap moment.
Yeah.
Like you said.
Love you, man. Love y'all.
Probably to tell them to turn the air. They need to turn that thermostat up so they got like on 64.
Y'all gonna, once y'all get started dancing and moving, I think it'll be better.
Okay. Go ahead before you fall. Don't fall. Yeah, listen, fall.
Praise God. Hello, everybody. This is the moment that I've been waiting for. I couldn't wait till this happened. But let me go back. Piggyback on what Miss Gloria said. She was right. But see, with Jeremy, he was living with us. And we saw Mo, we met Mo. We had welcome in, open arms. I mean, I love her there. Her smile, her person, her spirit just grab, you know, it just hold on to you. And I was like, girl, you're my daughter, in heart. I don't know where you came from, but you're my daughter. And she laughed at me, and she's like, I love both of y'all, but let me go on the way back. Jeremy, at the time, he was into his ministry. Jeremy was reading the Bible and trying to do his good deed.
Amen.
And he was not looking for anyone. He just wanted to just learn him at the time. And he did. But when he introduced us to Mo, and I said, Jim, we got to keep her. We got to get Jim out the house. But in any case, they got mad at one another. They just meet each other. And they got mad. And Mo called. And she said, it's Jeremy there. He's not asking for him. Jim said, don't tell him I'm here. Yeah, he is. He is there, sweet. I'm coming over. Can I come over? Yeah, come on over, girl. I ain't going to tell you. You come. Jeff said, you should have talked to him first. We got to get Jeremy out the house.
Words can't even explain how I feel about them as a couple, but as Mo, when we first met, the first time she'd ever came to my house for Jaden's, I think it was a 9th birthday, 8th birthday, or something like that. And she came in and this young lady, she got such a bubbly, beautiful spirit, and came in like Mo don't meet strangers, you know. So, you know, she came in and she having a good time, and me and her was just standing in the kitchen talking. And I think she was fixing some food, and I think I was fixing a drink. And she said, and we were just talking, she said, they pops, that's gonna be my husband. Just like day one, I said, okay, well, I sure hope so, okay. You know? And here we are, how many years later? What, 5 years later? 4 years later. She know I love her, man. I feel like she's so genuine, so loving. And the main thing, is that I know she come from good stock.
Yes.
She came from good stock. She know the Lord. She loved the Lord. She loved family. And she came to court. She came to court.
Y'all don't understand. She can really cook.
Well, you know, a lot of times, it's hard, you know, in this day and time, to find a somebody that young lady that love the Lord, love family, love enjoy. I mean, just having fun, and can cook. And so Jeremy would have this go through his little thing, you know, like because he's. You know, I'm trying to find myself, Dad, and you know. And I told him, I said, see, man, look here. If you let this one get past you, you'll regret it years later. I say, she's a good girl. See, they know me. I'm that dad that looks at the people that they bring around, their boyfriend, their girlfriend, and I'd be like Stevie. That one ain't right. They say, no, Dad, she got it. Okay, that one ain't right. This one here, this is a keeper. You know, so this is a keeper. And they're perfect together. So I'm glad to welcome you into my family. Well, you always, she's been in my family already, but I'm for official as husband and wife. So do me a favor, lift y'all glass and let's give a toast to Jeremy and Mo, the Garlands.
Years.
Hey, yeah, but y'all right there, y'all right on our doorstep.
My name's Aviva. I'm one of Cody's best friends. I'm here to say that I'm
here to go. I'll hold on to that and let me get you mic'd up. Sorry. There you go.
I'm so happy for her. We've been on each other since freshman year in high school, and I tell her all the time, you know, she is God sent, because God sent her to me as a friend in a moment where I felt lonely, and we've been friends ever since. Each other go through so many things, from children to just
help me.
Struggles,
what am I going to do? Okay.
Very special.
I'm going to make some jokes.
So
yeah.
That you decided to keep her and you didn't let your finding yourself
help me
leave her. So I'm so happy, and I know wonderful things are going to come.
Yeah.
And it's just such a blessing to see you guys together. And I pray that, you know, you guys continue to communicate and talk things through. Seeing you as a now wife, but I know you're gonna be a wonderful wife because you're always willing to sacrifice how you feel. And that's one thing about Monique. She will put her feelings aside. And for anybody, even when I tell her no and put your foot down, she's like, I just want to keep the peace. So, and Jeremy's always there to protect her and have her back. And it's just really refreshing. And so, many blessings. I'm very thankful. Raise your glasses. And let's give Jeremy and Monique Garland a toast.
Okay. Nah, because it's too much. Hello, y'all. My name is Kiara. Hello, y'all. My name is Kiara. I'm Monique, one of Monique's best friends. I wrote a whole thing on a piece of paper, and I can't even read it, y'all. I don't have my glasses on. So I just want to say first, glory to God.
Amen.
He's in the midst of this relationship.
Amen.
All right. So I've been knowing Monique since we were 6 years old. We both ran track for Track Houston. Well, no, she ran, I walked. But she was so nice to me. Even though I was a race walker, she was still, that was my friend. She was the track star and I was the walker. And it was cool. We would spend every weekend in each other's tents eating grapes, drinking Gatorades the whole day. Because back in the day, track meets, you were there all day. And so we separated. You know, I went to another track group and she stayed with Track Houston. And we ended up meeting back again in middle school. That's how I know this is a divine friendship from God. So I'm walking in the hallway, as she said, with my color contacts. And I'm walking. She said, Kiara. I said, Monique. We was like, hey. And y'all, we was tight the whole middle school. There were some girls that was trying to fight me, y'all, but y'all know Monique's low-key Mike Tyson with them hands. And so we had planned to meet up with them after school. They didn't show up because they said they didn't want to fight me no more. But it's because she was there with me, though. But you know what? That's how Monique is, though. She's a protector. She's a lover. She won't fight unless she's fighting for somebody else. We end up separating again, y'all, high school. That's when she met Khadija. And then I went to a toga party in San Antonio. And I was with a group of girls and they just wanted to walk around and look cute, but I wanted to dance. Y'all, guess who I saw there at the toga party? Monique. We like, Monique, she like here. We left our group of friends, y'all, they almost left us. And we had a blast. We have been friends ever since, well, we've been friends since six years old, but I've seen Monique go through her ups and downs, y'all. Monique went through hell. But I saw her fight a way that I've never seen nobody else fight before. She has hustled her butt off. She deserves to be a wife. If anybody mad that she's a wife, then maybe you could take some pages out of her book. Because one thing about me, I'm taking pages out of that book right there. I look up to Monique. And I can only pray that I am as good of a friend to her as she has been to me. I love her so much, all my heart. And she's a sister that I never had. She's been there for me, never judged me, and I've been there for her as well. I'm sorry I'm going all over y'all, but I'm gonna go over. Jeremy, I love you so much. I don't call guys my brother. That's not my biological brother. I always thought that was weird. But I love him so much. He's like my brother. I can talk to him like he's my brother. He's such a great man. Amen. They deserve each other, and I'm just so proud. And I can't wait to be the third wheel all the time, because that's what I am now. I'm single. I love y'all so much. Okay, I'm done. Bye. Oh, y'all, raise your glasses up. Toast into the Garlands, my sister and my brother, and keeping God first always and forever.
Yeah, I'll give it up for all the toasts. Wow, the Garlands! Sing a song or whatever, the song that you think I was going to do, I'm not going to do. I went ahead and wrote some lyrics because I read their bio, and I just put a few lyrics to this. But one thing I want y'all to do, if you are a couple, I want y'all to get up and get out on the dance floor. Don't let me call y'all Nikki and Pat, Joe and Ty, all of the couples, Steve and your boo. Congratulations to the Garlands. Come on, come on. I got my words.
You keep running across my mind. 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 Keep running across my mind. I was skeptical and didn't know what to do, but I found my love in you. Listen. When we first met, we were skeptical, but found out this love was wonderful. Oh yeah. Remember when we chatted here and there? You looked me in my eyes and we stopped to stare. Oh yeah. In love with you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, that's why you keep running across my mind. 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 I finally found my lover and my friend. We gonna ride this journey to the end. Oh yeah. So excited to see what God has in store. Trusting Him with our marriage, He will bless us more and more and more and more and more. We've been through some ups and some downs, and even this craziness all around. Oh yeah, oh. But it's still, you keep running across my mind. You keep running across my mind. You keep. Ooh, yeah, we gotta trust in God, y'all. Ooh, yeah. God even brought our families together to witness our vows in this beautiful weather, 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 weather.
Thank you. that you did, and you can't live without it. You ain't got no friends, and it's bad if you ain't got it.
Thank you. Thank you.
I got.
Okay, so we can throw the booty.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, you want to do it?
Both hands, hold her hand there.
She's behind me or?
Yeah, right there's top.
And action. We're going to pretend.
Yeah.
Thank you. Light it up.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go inside.
Give us 5 minutes. All right, we got it. It's a minute or so. I gotta cut mine.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Cut
no, no, no. You purred, baby.
Oh man, you right.
No, you purred. You purred.
That's right.
Night, baby.
Cool, man.
Follow the lights song.
Listen, you know you're added to the group now.
Oh yeah. Oh,
you
man.
You part of the family now, baby.
I feel like this whole other family, hero. I feel like the fraternity, man.
Oh, listen, they gonna play a song for us in a minute.
Okay.
We out. It's gonna be
Let's
us.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Right. Whole new family.
Let's do it. Yeah, man.
Mr. and Mrs. Garland.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby.
Oh, yeah.
That's it.
Nice.
Come on,
big bro.
Fire, go ahead.
Oh, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that's what I needed right here.
Yes, sir.
The drinks are okay, but this right here.
Yeah, this is what we do here. Yeah.
Yes, sir. That feels good. Mm. Sir.
Toast to the garden.
Yeah, to the garden.
To them Garland.
To the new family.
Yes, sir. Garland.
Capital G, baby.
Yeah.
Got it.
I'm gonna make it.
Oh, Corpus Christi on the 24th. I can go towards Houston, but I have to go a little bit towards.
Okay, that works.
And then I can just drop
off. Let me know if you can recover.
I have a strong feeling I can.
If you can, let me know.
I'm gonna make it. get the sound. A journey which along the way will bring to you new color, new dimension, new level. We're all ready. I throw this switch.
Got these bones running around. watching you is all that I can do. And now, speechless, you already know that you're my weakness. After all this time, I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room. Something to me.